Good morning.
Too humble.
How are you this morning?
Happy Monday.
Indeed. Monday morning it is. Monday morning and the sun is shining in our part of the world. What's the sun doing in your part of the world?
Yes.
In our part of the world, it's a gorgeous day.
Morning, Shirley.
Hi.
Lovely to have you with us. Hi, Sally and Ian.
From Nebraska.
Nebraska.
Anna Marie, lovely to have you with
Morning.
Us. Grab a coffee.
Just
enjoy.
Grab a cuppa.
Pat, lovely to see you.
Come and sit in our lounge, will you? Yes, come and take a seat. Morning, Lorraine. Morning, Phil. Monday morning.
Mandy, good to see you.
Are we day 18?
I don't know. We should have a special counter, shouldn't we?
I don't know what
of,
day
of
is.
Of what day of lockdown this is.
I know what
Diane,
day is,
it's lovely
morning,
to see
IJ,
you.
Morning, IJ. Morning, Pat. I don't know what day of lockdown we are.
I'm not sure, but the days are blending into one, and especially now the sun is coming out. Yesterday we went out for our morning run, for our piece of exercise, and we actually got a slightly sunburnt face.
We did. Yes, we did.
Which is pretty good for April, beginning of April.
Yeah. And the beaches were empty, so I've had some messages from people saying, is everyone obeying the rules down there? Yes, we are. Planet Thanet is being very, very good, and they're staying away from the beach, just coming out for exercise, and then going back in.
Indeed. Steve Nolan, it's a good thing to see you this morning.
So, Monday morning, how are you? Did you sleep well last night? Are you sleeping well? Are you doing enough to have you sleep well?
Carolyn, it's good to have you with us.
Yes. Good morning, Christine. How are you all? Tell us how you are. Just put up the comments. Don't be scared to get involved. Grab a tea or coffee, or if you're eating your breakfast, that's not a problem at all.
Hi, Michelle.
Morning, Maria. Welcome. Monday morning, coffee morning.
It is, and there's lots of good news, good things to talk about. You know, we're always going to give you a big dollop of positivity.
Positive vibes.
And we want to give you those vibes for this Monday morning to start your week.
Yes.
Jackie Lloyd, it's lovely to see you.
Hi,
here.
Lucy.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi, Lucy. IJ slept well.
Oh,
so happy you're
God,
on annual
good.
Leave this week. Yeah, Phil slept a bit better last night, got more than 4 hours. Well, that's a win, isn't it?
Oh, goodness,
wow.
Yes.
Well done. Yes, so positivity, positive vibes in this lounge only.
Yes, and that was started off yesterday by the Queen, who came online.
Dear Queenie.
Yes, and spoke to us in our lounge. I don't know whether she spoke to you in your lounge, but she came directly to our lounge. In actual fact, we have her later on. We have, as a special guest, you're going to have to wait for it though, the Queen is coming to speak to the TOJO Coffee Morning.
Yes.
But
you have never seen anything like it before.
But yesterday we saw her online and she was talking about the importance of prayer and meditation and slowing down. And that's our subject today. Mm-hmm. Our word of wisdom today comes from Proverbs 14:30. A tranquil heart brings life to the bones. A tranquil heart brings life to the bones. What does it mean to have a tranquil heart?
Yes. Morning, Hannah. Morning, Steve. Come and join us. Have a cuppa. We're just spreading some positive vibes about your Monday morning. Isolation. How are you all faring in isolation today? I think we're about day 18, 19. Who knows? It needs to be an advent calendar, doesn't it? But open the other way. So, you know, lockdown kind of advent thing. And you open up a day on the next day and you get a prize.
Finally clear.
Yeah.
All clear.
Yeah, that's right. And you just keep on giving yourself gifts with each time the lockdown. Just open up a new window.
So who saw the Queen? Who saw the Queen? Was she on form? Did you think she was looking good? I think she's a brilliant old lady.
Is she 93? No,
absolutely brilliant. Somebody here has just said Rule Britannia, excellent stuff. Very good. We're
morning,
not going
Debs.
To sing that.
Morning, Debs. I've got some exciting news for you, Debs. Is that the I was going to save this to Wildlife Corner.
Go on. Hang on. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do Wildlife Corner, going direct to our reporter, You got a jingle as well.
That's it. So wildlife corner is so exciting. So first of all, Wingham Wildlife Park are going live every day, and they are doing wild feeding, live feeding. So yesterday was penguins, and the other day, Debs, was giraffes. And that's what made me think of you. Yeah.
Oh.
They've just had I think it was a newborn just given birth, and they've also had this new kind of bear given birth there as well. So Wingham Wildlife Park, if you have any kids as well, or like me, you are a big kid, I watch them feeding their animals every day.
And that's the penguins, isn't it?
Penguins yesterday.
Okay.
Penguins yesterday. But they feed the giraffes, they feed the bears, and they're right in there with them, like live.
Joe bounced up yesterday, she said, oh, look, they're feeding the penguins. And I'm thinking, like, we don't have penguins. And I'm going to the window to look outside, thinking we've got penguins in Margate. No, it's online.
Debs, you can go back, and if you have a look on Wingham Wildlife Park, I think it may be in the feed there. So have a little look. I think they keep all their videos, which is so cool. Other things in Wildlife Corner. Yes, I don't know if Jay's on, perhaps Jay's watching with Debs, I'm not sure. Chris Packham.
Hey, the Saint Chris.
He's one of my heroes.
If you love Chris Packham, show the love now. Press that heart button. We love Chris Packham.
We do love Chris Packham. I think he's going to be the next David Attenborough, but that's just my personal opinion. Mm. Perhaps I'm throwing the cat amongst the pigeons there, I don't know. However, he has started this new group on Facebook, and it is called the Self-Isolating Bird Club. Yes.
I can see you're very excited about that. There's a general sense of silence there.
So it's called the Self-Isolating Bird Club. You do have to ask for permission to join. But once you're in there, there's people sharing pictures about their birds. All over the country, there's videos of Chris puts videos up there as well. He goes live on the group as well, which I think is kind of cool at the same time. And also, Jay sent me some more pictures of some blue tits yesterday.
Oh, great. Which we'll be putting up. Our next gallery is going to be Wednesday. Mm-hmm. On Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
We've got
gallery.
Some galleries. So, Zip, send him your photos. Not just photos, but if your kids have done stuff, or you have some kids who watch this, do a little picture for us. Draw something out. Take a photo of it and send it to
us.
I
wonder if Maria can send us any pictures of lambs.
Oh, yes. Yes. The lambs are lambing right now, aren't they?
Yep.
Is that right, Maria? The lambs are lambing? If the lambs are lambing, send us a bit of video footage. We could do a little country file bit, couldn't we?
Country file.
See, this is how we want this to be. Interactive.
Yes, that's my wildlife corner anyway. I'm sure there are other things that will spring to mind through it. But yes, we've got, Pat has got birds visiting in her garden, singing to her. Oh, it's a good time of year. Someone woke up this morning and put on Facebook with the dawn chorus. The dawn chorus was specifically loud this morning. And so they videoed it and recorded it and popped it up for us to hear. Absolutely beautiful. And that's another way that you can cultivate a tranquil heart, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, the nature around us is designed to bring us to peace.
Ooh.
It's been scientifically proven that by walking in a forest brings you to peace.
Yep.
That by listening to the sound of waves, it brings you to peace. And this sort of thing is designed, it's out there for us. It's nature's tranquilizer, it's nature's feel-good pill. Yep. And it costs the NHS a lot less. And it actually works. They've found it scientifically, it works at least twice as powerfully as the most powerful antidepressants. And those of you who have suffered with depression, and I know there's some folks here, and anxiety and stuff, you know the power of going to the forest or going to to nature and just letting that minister to you. Now, we've talked about this before, and this gives us an opportunity just to mention to you that our YouTube channel, which thank you so much, everybody,
for signing up to. Yes.
If you haven't registered, if you haven't subscribed yet to our YouTube channel, it's Tojo Fitness. Would love you to. And what we've started doing is we've started putting these, repackaging them, and putting them on as catch-up TV. So you're able to catch up with Neil Diamond. We had Neil Diamond, if you remember, a couple of days ago. And you can catch up with all your favourite stuff that you missed because we can't keep them on Facebook indefinitely.
No, that's right. So yes, Tranquil Heart. It brings you, God created creation to like bring us out of our own heads.
Mm.
Because being in your head is one of the most uncomfortable things you can be.
Yeah.
Pink wrote a song that said, "Don't let me get me." It was the lyrics in a song. And it's like, who's me? Like, things that he has created. And so that's a huge way of bringing us to peace.
Yeah.
Of getting the heart just to settle down. You know, exactly the same as you would talk to a child. Just settle down. It's going to be all right. Have some calm. Have some tranquility. It's going to be all right. And that's kind of what the bird singing to you does.
What we've got to remember is that it's our brains that get us into this mess. The headspaces, we talk about headspaces. Your head can't get you out of a headspace because your head got you into the headspace, right? You can't think yourself out of toxic thoughts because it's thoughts that are the problem. And this is why even Jesus said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. He didn't say out of your brain. He said, out of your belly. There's a different place you've got to go to in order for the joy to flow, the tranquility to flow, all the things we want. Yeah. And the more we try and figure it out, the more trapped we become by it. And so, by Proverbs 14:30, which is our word of wisdom for the day, a tranquil heart brings life to the bones.
Oh, yeah.
That tranquility of heart isn't going to come by us figuring it out, but
no
by
logic.
Us finding a different source. And that's what we're going to be keep dipping into throughout the day. But we do want to talk about some other good news that's happening in the world. David Loveday, it's lovely to see you here. How's Pat? Please let us know.
Yeah.
Pat was very ill in hospital and we've been praying for her.
Mm-hmm.
And David, if you would like to, if you're able to let us know how she is, I'm sure the folks here would love to send their love.
Just to, you know, we've got two different feeds going up here. We've got my live feed and Tom's live feed. So if you're hearing things that you think, where is that? Don't panic. Your Facebook hasn't fritzed. It's just we've got two different feeds coming up. Good news.
So we have had some other things in the good news. Is there has been street dancing reported in Cheshire, of all places, in a rather, what looks like a rather posh street in Cheshire.
Social distancing dancing.
Mm-hmm. Yes. People have come out of their houses not just to applaud, but to dance, apparently to Tom Jones.
11 o'clock every day, all the residents come out of their house and they put Tom Jones on. It's not unusual. And they dance together in the street just to keep morale up.
Can you believe that?
Yeah,
in posh parts of Cheshire, people are dancing on the street.
Yeah, they wouldn't be dancing to R&B stuff, would they?
No, it's not in Cheshire.
It's got to be Tom Jones.
Yes. It's not unusual. That's the only bit I know.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Just a little clip.
I'm not sure the people in the flats here would dance, though.
No.
In other news, did you know that in India, there's been some twins born? The quarantine twins, and their mum and dad have named them Corona and COVID.
Brilliant.
Corona and COVID. That's always going to be a memory for them, isn't it? These two twins born in India, and their parents have called them Corona and COVID.
Do you, Corona, take this man to be your lawful wedded husband?
I think, is there going to be a lot of Corona and COVID names for babies around this time?
This happened during the Black Death, whether there were children born called bubonic plague.
Yeah, people called Rose, ring a roses.
That's deep. That's a Phoebe moment, that is. That's a Phoebe moment.
I don't know. Yeah, see, Sally, COVID is the boy.
And Corona is the girl. There we go. Well, Corona's okay, because Corona means crown.
Does it?
Crown, yes.
It's also a beer.
So, crown. Exactly, crown.
Which is the only beer left over in the supermarket, by the way.
Mm.
Everyone else has taken all the other beers and just left Corona on the shelf.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
Back to the Black Plague.
Sorry.
in the plague of 1665 to 1666. Let nobody tell you that we don't deal with the big subjects on this. And in 1665 to 1666, plague swept across Europe. There was no such thing as social distancing then. So they came up with a whole bunch of different ideas. No more crazy than some of the crazy ideas circulating on the internet today about how you can be safe from plague. And a number of them, one of them was to light an indoor bonfire.
I think most people did that yesterday in their garden, didn't they? They had barbecues.
Barbecues, yes, an indoor bonfire.
Indoor bonfire.
The idea was that you can smoke out the plague. Another one was where we get the phrase shutting up shop. Mm-hmm. And if you were found to have the plague, they would quite literally come and they would shut your door and they would nail your doors and your windows shut and put boards over them and just put your food, bring your food to you if you were lucky, and put it through a little hole they had left like a cat flap in your door.
Do you reckon we should do that today? Stop people going out?
I think that would be pretty severe.
Come and nail people's doors shut?
And that's where the idea of shutting up shop comes from.
What?
And so if you were in 1665, perhaps, and a shop owner, you wouldn't just be voluntarily isolating. You would have somebody nailing your door shut and then somebody shoving something under the door.
That's nice.
The report I read actually said that they put it under the door. I'm assuming they made like a cat flap, because putting it under the floor, the only thing that would go under there is chapatis.
Maybe.
Personal pomanders were important. That was you gathered herbs and spices and you made them into a little package which you wore around your neck, and it released fragrance because the plague
full of stuff
didn't
this morning,
like
isn't he?
Fragrance. And my personal favorite is the pigeon body scrub, where they would take pigeons and they would chop them up and rub them on their body.
Wow, I can see that we're actually retaining numbers at the moment, so perhaps this is something that was interesting to you.
I wonder whether this is something we need to learn from the Great Plague. Is anybody willing to try a pigeon body scrub?
No, absolutely not.
Mm.
No.
If you do, please let us know on the back of a self-addressed envelope.
That's not going to make Wildlife Corner, by the way. I'm just putting it out there.
Please make sure that the pigeon has died of natural causes before you scrub it on your body.
Lovely. Excellent. Can we get back to having a tranquil heart?
Let's go back to a tranquil heart now, shall we?
Yeah, that's really good. Yeah, see, a pocket full of posies. A tissue.
We all fall down.
Gosh. If that's where it's come from.
No, see, that's where they got it wrong. A tissue, we catch it and bin it. That would be the new way of singing that.
Yeah, see, Caroline here, certainly not with thanet pigeons. No, I'd totally agree with you there. Talking about birds again, I saw a cormorant yesterday, and I took a picture of it on my Facebook. Someone called it a little bird table in the sea.
It's a little dot in the middle of the picture.
No, he was spreading his wings apart because cormorants are not waterproof. Like all the other birdies of the sea, cormorants are not waterproof. So it means they have to find somewhere on dry land once they've done all their diving, and they have to open up their bat wings like this and dry in the sun.
Hey, very, very interesting.
Yes. We're full of interesting facts this morning, aren't we? So a tranquil heart, in other names.
What stops us having a tranquil heart?
Yeah, what's the stuff that gets in the way?
And I would suggest that perhaps the thing which stops us having a tranquil heart more than anything else is that stabbing hurt of sorrow and pain and suffering, which causes us to react to other people in a wrong way, which perpetuates this cycle of hurt and pain and sorrow. Have you ever been ill? You know, you've got gut rot and somebody comes up to you and asks you how you are and you're you just don't feel tranquil, you don't feel cool, you don't feel
snappy.
You feel snappy. You know, when us guys are ill, we get a bit snappy sometimes. I don't know whether that's true. I tend to think perhaps not. But apparently it's true that we get snappy when we're ill. But it's true, certainly, that when we are suffering psychological pain.
Yeah. That we try and make other people suffer.
That we make, even if we're not trying to, we just make other people around us suffer. It's like we generate a field of pain around us, a field of suffering.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to a room where there's somebody and they are absolutely at peace, they're joyful, and they generate this field of joy, this field of peace, and it brings you back to your place of center?
Yeah.
And so it is that when we suffer internally, we generate a field of suffering that extends out past us, and your dog will know about it.
Yes,
your
true.
Your dog knows when you're suffering.
It's true.
The cats know when you're suffering.
No, they don't.
And other people know when you're suffering. And if it doesn't elicit empathy, yeah, it actually generates problems yourself. Like when we went to the shop the other day, and as we walked in, there was such a sense, a tense sense.
Oh, it was electric, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was...
Yes.
Yeah.
And so having a tranquil heart brings life not just to your bones, but to the bones of everyone around you. And we're going to talk today about how we deal with that stabbing knife of hurt, how we deal with that sorrow. Because that word tranquil there can also mean healed.
Yeah.
A healed heart.
Yeah, that's right.
Brings life to the bones. You say, yeah, look, Tom, Joe, it's okay. But for us, you don't understand what's happened in our life that's made us feel this way.
Yeah.
And there are things which happen to us which destroy us inside.
Mm.
And unless we find a way of healing that heart, then that rottenness to the bones, that dis-ease of the bones will damage us. And it creates distress for everyone around us.
Yeah.
Did you have an update there from...
I did, but it went. There was an update. I think Pat's having an MRI this morning.
Okay.
But what Tom was saying there is that this is a kind of time here, and I've had some conversations with people where they said where they're not busy, it was the busyness that kept them distracted from actually dealing with the when the stuff hits the fan of life. And so when you find yourself with a bit of a surplus of time on your hands, these little things that we've swept under the rug tend to start from underneath the rug.
Yeah.
And that's okay, but don't put it back under the rug. Perhaps now's the time that we deal with it and move on, and you'll become a better person at the other end. Doesn't mean to say that you'll never have scars to carry with you, but our scars are our testimony.
Yeah.
Our scars are our story, and they're a way of showing hope to other people.
I thought it was interesting what the Queen was saying, where she said, it's funny, isn't it, to say that? I thought it was interesting what the Queen was saying to us yesterday, that to pray, to meditate, and to slow down. Those were the three things she said. Pray, meditate. To pray is to ask for help.
Yeah.
To meditate is to ponder, to think deeply, to allow yourself to go even beyond thought to the place of intuition.
Yeah.
And to slow down to enable yourself to do all these things.
Yeah.
And we have this wonderful opportunity to do some internal work now and heal ourselves of all the stuff in our past, all the skeletons in the closet, and to deal with the hurt, to deal with the sorrow.
Yeah.
And one of the things which stops us achieving peace is when we become driven.
Hmm.
When the Queen said about slowing down, we've spoken many, many times, haven't we, about living at the pace of the plough, the pace of the plough. That is that we live life, for most of human life just went at the pace of a plough. The fastest you ever went was the pace of the oxen in front of your plough. Other than occasional moments when there was a war, or occasional moments during a hunt or a party. But other than those three things, pretty much the fastest you went was the pace of the plough.
Yeah.
Added to that, Sundays, the Sabbath, nothing happened.
Yeah.
It was a total downtime, like today's.
Weren't allowed to cook, weren't allowed to put lights on.
Yeah, very, very little could happen.
Yeah.
Added to that, especially if you lived in countries like the UK, you had the winter months, very, very little happened in the winter months. You gathered in your stuff to the barn during the summer, and in the winter you hunkered down, you slept a lot. You regathered your strength. And in the spring, you went out, tilled your fields again, had babies, and parted. And so you,
COVID and Corona.
This wonderful rhythm of life, which we've lost.
Yeah.
And in losing that rhythm, we've lost our peace.
Mm. I think what's incredible, we were talking about this yesterday on our walk, is that now is the time we actually get to start again, isn't it?
Mm.
If you do have this time on your hands, perhaps you've incorporated things into your life which you think, actually, I'd really like to keep this time. I really want to ring fence this time because this time is actually good for my mental health, or this time is good for my spirit life, or this time has actually really helped me. And that's normally the time that we say, oh, I don't have time for because I'm busy. And so now we're actually finding that perhaps this is a time where we put into place the things that are important first, and then allow our life to expand from that centre.
Mm.
Does that make sense?
Mm.
So you think these are the things that are important, and then we build from the inside out.
This is something which we're doing this week. We're taking time to readjust our life, to relook at our life and say, look, if life is giving us another opportunity for a new chapter, then what do we want that chapter to look like? What rhythm of life do we want? We know we don't want the same rhythm of life we had before.
Yeah.
And so we're going to change it up. We're changing it up to say we're going to have a rhythm of, perhaps you might say, I want a rhythm of prayer, of meditation, in the mornings and evenings.
Silence.
A time of silence.
Yeah.
I want to slow down. So now you've got the time to work out, how do I do that? Because we are on this never stop, merry-go-round. And we've never able to get off until the day we die, but we've got an opportunity, friends. This is a world-class opportunity to reevaluate our lives and to get off of this merry-go-round. And as we were saying about the pace of the plow, if you've ever ploughed with an oxen, and we have in Zimbabwe, is you can't beat that oxen and make it go faster. If you beat the oxen, it just stops. You can't incentivize the oxen by giving it more money to go faster. You can't give the oxen energy drinks. You can't do any of those things. That oxen is going to go at that pace. But we've managed to work out that we can incentivize people with money. We can give them energy drinks, excess amounts of caffeine.
Yep.
We can take away their sleep. We can take away the natural order of things so they no longer have downtime in the winter. We've taken away Sabbaths so they no longer have a day off. Everything is 24/7. Go, 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 go. And now people, the high flyers in London, are having to do so much. And even the low flyers do so much and fill their lives with so much just to keep going, that we're relying on drugs to keep us going. And that is a driven life, and that isn't a tranquil life.
No, that's right. And like Angie says here, that's the way we should be living. And people suffer from SAD because their bodies need to hibernate.
Yeah.
There's that, and I do in the winter, as soon as the dark hits, it could be 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and I'm like, I need to go to bed. Mm. That's our bodies are kind of prescribed and designed in such of a way that when it's light, you're awake, and when it's dark, you're asleep, I guess. I don't know, perhaps that's just my simple brain thinking.
I think we've managed to find a way to artificially stimulate human beings.
Mm.
You would never see an animal which is normally hibernates in the winter. You wouldn't look at it and say, you're being lazy, you should do something different. You understand that's the way nature designed us.
Yeah.
And if there's something that comes out of this, I hope it's a time for us to turn around, re-examine our lives as human beings and say, how do I reconnect with my core? How do I reconnect with what it is to be a real human being, as opposed to this artificial human intelligence which human beings are trying to become?
Yeah.
We're not artificial intelligence. We're human beings deeply connected to nature, to the natural biorhythms of life, and the seasons around us, and to reconnect with that and to find there comes peace.
Yeah, that's right. Angie's just said here, really interesting point here. Pineal gland, thank you, controls our sleep patterns, and it's controlled by light. So correct me if I'm wrong, that if you do have like SAD in the winter, you have to have one of these lights.
A sun lamp
that will wake you up naturally. Because getting up in the dark, you're like, oh my gosh, I don't think I can do this. And plying yourself with copious amounts of caffeine just to try and get through the day. But this is our chance to reset. Press, you know, when you're resetting your iPhone and it comes back up again and the battery's working better. This is our chance to reset ourselves as well as our lives. And the kids will thank you for it, I think, as setting a new example.
We want a life that is less driven. If you want a life that is less driven, now maybe you're an adrenaline junkie and that's gone into the rest of your life. And now your kids have no time with you. Your marriages, you have no time for each other. You don't know your community because all you do, you live in the house you live in and then you travel to work and you travel back and you travel to work, travel back. You have no community. If you're saying, look, I want to detach from this, I want a more organic life, then this is your opportunity.
Right. And I think we've experimented. First of all, in community, the amount of people that have been getting to know their neighbours now, I think that's incredible.
Yeah.
The proper kind of wartime spirit has come upon us in our streets and in our apartment blocks. And also, I've totally lost my train of thought.
Have you?
Yes, happens when you get older, doesn't it? but also, we've experimented with the fact that we're not buying loads of stuff.
Yeah.
So shops have shut. So we no longer have the retail therapy hit that we normally would do. We're saving money. And so I think this is a whole massive experiment for us of, are we able to really start again on this? Exciting times.
On the way home yesterday, we were coming home and normally you'd come home, you're feeling a bit thirsty, you know, you're normally carrying a bottle of water or something, and we didn't have anything. You know, it's like being a kid again. We went out for a run and on the way round we saw somebody else, another one of our friends, and they were on their bike and it was just kind of...
that was nice.
And we were like, no, and we're thirsty now, a bit peckish, what are we going to do? You'd normally drop in Costa, spend 10 quid, 15 quid, get a bit of brownie, you know, a cup of coffee or whatever, and sit there. And we said, you know, let's go home, let's make a cup of tea and have a slice of cake.
We didn't have a slice of cake, but we had a drink when we got home.
Yeah.
But it feels like, at the moment, I feel like a kid in the summer holidays. You know, that best summer holidays that you had when you was at school, perhaps it was between, like... primary school and secondary school, you had no worries really, and you were just a bit carefree. And I guess yes, we have concerns and yes, we have worries, but they're not actually... I think we're training ourselves them not to take over, to try and have that tranquility.
And that's hard. I think coming back to what the Queen was talking about yesterday, pray, to meditate, and to slow down. Now, we have said that we would try and get the Queen on here. And while we're at our maximum viewing capacity now, we are going to see if we can get the Queen to come and speak to us. We've worked really hard. Our people have worked with their people.
Are you ready?
And we think we're ready for this. We're going to... Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for the Queen? Here we go.
I shall take a seat.
Take a back seat. Here we go. Here we go.
There we are. There we go. We promised you Queen.
And we gave you the Queen. Giving us some good advice that the show must go on.
Absolutely. People are loving that this morning. you've got to have a bit of a...
Does Sally and Ian say they are not amused?
So that was Queen coming to you live on the Tojo Coffee Morning. Who are we going to get on Wednesday?
I don't know. But if you look at the Tojo catch-ups on our YouTube channel at Tojo Fitness, please subscribe to that. Yeah. And on Tojo catch-ups, it's seamless.
Yes.
Instead of me fumbling and dropping the iPad, it seamlessly will come onto your screen.
Yes. So lastly, we just want to talk to you just a little bit about your activity of the day.
Yes, what are you doing?
How are you keeping active? So I'm seeing people that are digging their gardens. We've seen lots of videos and photos of people out on their walks. How are you keeping active? Are you staying in line? are you staying in line with the government guidelines of going out for your daily exercise?
Mm.
How are you staying active? There was a BBC bulletin that said people are staying active by karate classes, window bingo, and what was the other? I think it was gardening or something along those lines. Window bingo sounds quite nice.
Online karate classes. Online That's interesting.
Karate classes.
Mm. Yes. Maybe we could do some online karate classes. That would be interesting.
Oh, no. You wouldn't want to see that.
What is your fitness focus for us today? Today is Monday. That means Monday's leg day. And as it's a nice day, we will be marching up and down our car park with each other on each other's shoulders, doing lunges and stuff like that. We may even film that.
Oh, I don't think so.
But if you're going to do lunges up and down your car park or your garden with your wife or your husband on your shoulder, please make sure you video it. Because if it all goes Pete Tong, it will make great viewing.
Did you say extra fries? Very good, Debs. So we've got people playing games with the cats, staying active by working, bike ride, painting the hallway. Oh, people are doing all their DIY things as well, aren't they?
Somebody's doing body combat.
Body
combat.
Oh,
that's because they're going shopping. Is that?
Perhaps that's, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It does feel like body combat sometimes going shopping, doesn't it? Lorraine's doing walking, shopping, housework, school. Oh, Zoom chats. Isn't Zoom one of the most amazing apps that we have at the moment?
Yeah, we Zoom in with members of our family and with people we do. We've been doing some Bible studies, some small groups.
Yeah.
And some, we've been thinking about all sorts of different things that we could do during this time to bring people together. So we're going to throw some ideas out there. Just let us know what you think, if that would be a good thing. We're thinking of doing an epilogue at the end of each day, a 15-minute epilogue, which will be like a spiritual coming to rest. Do you remember back in the days, those of you who were old enough, at midnight on the BBC, there was always a little show. It was a 10-minute show, and it was called Close Down or something like that. And it was just a 10-minute epilogue of the day and just with a spiritual content. And we're thinking of perhaps doing that. We're looking at doing a whole lot of online fitness sessions, and we can do that as well. And we're also thinking of doing some small groups. Just creating small groups, little Bible studies.
It doesn't have to be for people who don't
even
know the Bible.
Or even practice studies. You know, these days I'm more interested in doing the practice than reading the theory.
Yeah.
And so some of you might say, okay, I want to know how to pray. I want to learn how to meditate. And you don't have to be religious to learn how to meditate. I want to learn how to slow down. And so we're thinking we might be able to do that and do just a time of silence together, where we gather together on Zoom and just a silence and just spend that time in meditation. So
yeah, sometimes it's better to, when you first start off, you know, how the whole silence and solitude thing works, is sometimes it's better off when you've got someone kind of in the room with you on silence, because otherwise you'll get to like 2 minutes and go, yeah, that'll do. And then you're done. But sometimes you just got to, you have someone to help you with that discipline just to stay in that place.
Yeah.
Just to stay in that place. Well, we hope today has been a blessing for you. Lovely, lovely people of Facebook family. We're going to be here for you all the way through lockdown on Coffee Mornings, Monday, Wednesdays and Saturdays at 8:30 in the morning. And we pray that this has been a bit of a tranquil heart time for you. Merriment as well.
Yeah. Yeah. Remember to take the opportunity to find that place of tranquility.
Yeah.
Take the time. Now, I know some of you have got kids. You've been writing and sending us emails telling us that you've got all these kids and you want to kill them right now and you're trying to find peace and quiet.
Well, it's Easter holidays now as well, isn't it?
It is.
No schoolwork.
Put them in the garden. It's a nice day. Put them in the garden. Lock the door for a while. Go. Remember what we said the other day? Is Jesus said it first. He said, when you pray, lock the kids in the garden, go to your quiet place and there pray.
Or get the kids involved with you.
Indeed.
Yeah, You'd be amazed at how open they are to this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. So have an amazing Monday. Stay in touch. Don't be a stranger. We're going to be here for you. We're going to bring you some joy. We're going to bring you some hope, hopefully some peace from our lounge to your lounge.
We are back on Wednesday.
Wednesday. Tell your friends, morning. 8:30 in the morning. Tag them into these feeds if you want them to have a check.
Find out the YouTube catch-ups, and you can promote those. You can do watch parties on Facebook, or you can just take the YouTube catch-ups. People have been saying we want to be able to get our friends involved. Yeah. You can just tag them on that, send them the link to the YouTube catch-up, and they can see all that's going on.
It's virtual hugs, people.
God bless you all. Bye-bye now.
Bye.